the fourth exercise, simplify this expression. On seeing the expression itself, we can clearly identify that this is product of some form. Okay, so that is POS form. So let's take this a plus b as x. ஓகே ஸோ நம்ம ஜஸ்ட் இதை வந்து ஒரு சிம்பிளிஃபை பண்ணுறதுக்காக தான். ஓகே ஸோ ஏ ப்ளஸ் பி எப்படி எடுத்துக்கிறோம், எக்ஸ். ஸோ யூ ஜஸ்ட் அப்ளை எக்ஸ் இன்டு திஸ் ஃபங்க்ஷன், எக்ஸ் ப்ளஸ் சி, தென் எக்ஸ் ப்ளஸ் சி பார், அண்ட் திஸ் வில் கம் ஆஸ் இட் இஸ். ஓகே சி திஸ், கம்பேர் தீஸ் டூ. It is just like the distributive law. Okay, we know that a plus b into a plus c, which is equal to a plus bc. Okay, and you just compare these two, so we can write x plus C for A, and A, the answer is A. So here in place of A we have X and C, BC. Okay, and here the same term B, and here is C. Okay, so C, and what's your C term? CC, C bar. ஓகே ஸோ இதுதான் நான் சொன்னேன் எக்ஸ்ப்ரெஷனில், அதாவது நம்ம ரூல்ஸ்லேருந்து உங்களுக்கு வந்திருக்க எக்ஸ்ப்ரெஷனை ஜஸ்ட் கம்பேர் பண்ணுங்கள். எந்த இடத்துல ஏ இருக்குது, ஸோ ரூல்ஸில் எங்கே ஏ இருக்குது, ரூல்ஸில் எங்கே பி இருக்குது, அப்படி கம்பேர் பண்ணால் தான் உங்களால் ஆன்சர் கரெக்டாக எழுத முடியும். ஸோ எக்ஸ் ப்ளஸ் சி சி பார் அண்ட் திஸ் டேர்ம் ஆஸ் இட் இஸ் சி பார். ஓகே ஸோ then c c bar which gives 0, so x into, that is x and b bar plus c bar. Okay, so substitute the value of x, a plus b. Okay, see here we took x as a plus b. Okay, so, and we again substituted that a plus b complement c complement, and again you compare these two expression. See a plus b and a plus c. See here in terms of c we have b plus c. Okay, so you consider this term as c. Okay, so you we can again simplify like this, a plus bc. Okay, see here in terms of a we have a, and for b we have b only, and in terms of c we have b complement plus c complement. Okay, and now we can multiply this b inside the bracket, so b complement plus b c complement, and this term will become 0, and your final answer is a plus b complement. So this is your minimal product of some form. This is your fifth exercise. See here the truth table is given for two variable, and they are asking to minimize the product of some expression. Okay, so truth table is given, then how will you write the expression? In case of product of some, you have to write function when output is low. Okay, see in sum of product case you will be writing the function where the output is high, but here in POS you have to write the function where the output is low. Okay, so this is the very 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 important thing should be noted of. Okay, so write the function y is equal to, see first write the max terms. See this is POS, so max terms starting from 0, m0, m1, max term 2 and max term 3. Okay, so here you have to write the function where output is 0. So 0, So for 0, you'll be putting A. And for 1, you'll be writing complement. So A plus B bar into and then 0. A complement plus B complement. Okay, so this is your function. And see, this is just like A plus B into A plus C. Okay, so we know that A plus B into A plus C is equal to A plus BC. Okay, but see here A is there as it is, and see here is A, and this term is like A bar, complemented form. Okay, and see the second term here, B complement, B complement. Okay, so what you can do, you can just replace the positions. Okay, so B bar plus A into B bar plus A bar. Now your function is just like this rule. See the B bar, and here also A, A. Okay, and now you can write. See what is your answer according to this rule? A bar A plus BC. Okay, here in place of A we have B bar plus. What is that? See here in A, and in the place of C we have A bar. Okay, so and this term will become 0. So your answer will be Y is equal to B bar. Okay, and you can check the answer with this true table also. See here the answer, here the input is 0 and the output is the complemented one, and here the input is 1, output is the complemented 0 1 1 0. So Y is equal to B bar. Okay, in this way also you can check your answer from the truth table. This exercise is for converting the sum of product expression to SSOP. Okay, standard sum of product form. Up to these many exercises you have seen the standard SOP to minimal form. Okay, here you are going to see about minimal to standard form. Okay, so we have 3 rules for implementing this task. So what's the first task? Identifying the missing term in the given expression. Okay, so you have to find out what are the variables are missing in the given expression. Then multiplication. Okay, so you have to multiply the missing variables plus its complement. Okay, then neglect the repeated terms. Let's see in the example problem. See, this is the given expression f of a comma b comma c, ab plus abc complement plus bc. Here see this first product term, here c is missing. Okay, c is missing, and here also a is missing, and see in this term all the variables are available. Okay, so what is your second expression? What is your second condition? AB C plus C bar. This is what? Variables plus its complement. C plus C bar plus AB C bar plus, here A is missing, so A plus A bar BC. Okay, so now you are going to expand this term. ABC plus ABC bar plus ABC bar plus ABC plus A bar BC. Now what is what's your third condition? You are going to neglect the repeated terms. Here ABC is getting repeated, so I am eliminating one ABC term and keeping one term. And ABC bar, this is also repeating twice. So ABC bar plus, this is the final one, A bar BC. So this is the expression you got finally. Okay, see here all the terms are having all the variables. Okay, see ABC, ABC, either in complemented form or not complemented form. Okay, so all the variables are included. See, now check the positional value. Okay, so you know the positional value for SOP form, right? So just place the positional value 1, 1, 1 and 1, 1, 0. For complement, it's 0 and 0, 1, 1. Okay, see now count it in decimal, 4 plus 2 plus 1. So this is 7 and this is your 7th midterm, midterm 7. Okay, and see this ABC complement, 4 plus 2. This is 4 plus 2 is 6 and this is your 6th midterm. And see this 2 plus 1, this is your 3rd midterm. Okay, so you can simply write it as 3, 6, 7. Okay, so if the expression is given like this and the equal summation m value is given, okay, so if it is, if the value is asked, you can directly apply this value. Okay, so what I did, I just gave the positional values for this SOP form. Okay, see in SOP form we'll be placing 1 for the unprimed number, that is uncomplemented number, and 0 for the complemented variable. This is the exercise for converting POS to SPOS form. Okay, product of sum to standard product of sum. So first of all, you have to identify the missing variables. Okay, so just like in the previous exercise we have seen, here also you have to first of all identify the missing variables, then add with that variable and its complement separately. Okay, see, let's see this in the following exercise. So the third condition, neglect the repeated terms. Okay, so this is your exercise, f of ABC is equal to A and A plus C. Okay, so this is your POS form. Okay, so this is given in the POS form. Some terms added together. Okay, see here only A is here, but we can say this is also a sum term, A plus 0, A plus 1 or whatever. Okay, so this is also a sum term. Okay, so sum terms added together. So take this first term, A term. So what are the variables are missing? See, this function has three variables and here B and C are missing. Okay, so B and C are missing and here B is missing. Okay, so you have to make a clear note of this. Here we have to add B and C over here in this A term. Okay, so either it could be in complemented form or either it could be in what, not complemented form, we don't know for sure. Okay, so what are the possibilities are coming? See the possibilities of this term, A plus B bar plus C. Okay, so first the first possibility, then A plus B plus C bar, then A plus b bar plus c bar, then a plus b plus c. Okay, see here, first b, only b is complemented and c is not complemented. Here b is not complemented and c is complemented. Here both are complemented and here both are not complemented. So these are the four possibilities of this single term a. So then the second one, a plus c. Here a plus c and then b plus b bar. Okay. Here b is missing, right? So I am placing like this. Okay, so I am going to expand this term. So here a plus b bar plus c and then a plus b plus c bar, this term and this term, a plus b bar plus c bar, and here a plus b plus c, and I am going to multiply with this. So a plus c plus b and then a plus c plus b bar. Okay, see this term, these two terms are getting repeated, so I am taking only one, a plus b bar plus c bar. Okay, and see this, a plus b plus c and a plus b plus c. Okay, so these terms are replaced, so both are same. I am taking only one, a plus b plus c. And what are the two terms are left? These two terms are left, a plus b plus c bar and then a plus b bar plus c. Okay, so this is the final expression which is in SPOS form. Okay, so this expression is in POS form and this is your SPOS form. Okay, so you have to put or you have to apply the positional value for this expression. Okay, so in terms of POS, for the not complemented variable you will be placing 0 and for the complemented variables you will be giving 1 as the positional value. Okay, so and here also 0, 0, 0 and 0, 0, 1 for the complemented term and 0, 1, 0. Okay, so count this in a decimal format. See, use 4 to 1 codes. Okay, so 2 plus 1, 3 and this is your max term, which is represented by capital M, and then this is 0, so max term 0, and 4 to 1, so 1, max term 1, and 4 to, this is the second max term. Okay, so how can we write it in an expression? Pi of M, 0, 1, 2, 3. See the function f of a, b, c. Okay. So this is in terms of max term, max terms expression. Okay. And this is in terms of standard POS. And the given expression is POS. Okay. Now you will feel the difference of these three.